I had the chance to attend a seminar, a lecture with the farmers, and I enjoyed exchanging views and learning from the farmers. And these are, I would say, the grassroots, the farmers from the grassroots, the farmers from far, far mountains, and I would like to help them. But what would spur the price is the demand for the export market, which I have tried and been successful into bringing back our beans to that international market. And it needs the proper quality of the beans and also the quantity, the regularity of your shipment, so that your market will be happy when you have the regular shipments that they needed. In a single farm, you cannot get the quantity for an export market. So the only way that you can do that is to go to the farmers and consolidate the beans that they produce. With the help of other farmers around, you can have this quantity.
What grows on it?
34. Okay, pila ni ka farmers karon ang naga kuan ani involve aning imong wheat beans nga nagtapo karon dire.
Bali tulo ka farmers.
Okay. So ang pinakadaghan ani nga kuan kanang imuha. Okay. So sa imong tanaw karon, sa imong pagbaligya karon ni gayuna. Daghan pang sunod ani. Sunod ani yung mga kuha pang
wheat beans? Na, makuha gamay na lang kayo. Ito mga high pick itong unang harvest.
Armajaro is a big international commodity trader, and I was successful into proving to them that we can have this export back. And since then, last year, I started sending them the properly fermented beans, and I've been sending them during the high peak season. We were able to send something like 180 tons of cocoa beans. And since then, our farmers have been happy because of the development of the improvement in the price. Now we also have here with us in my farm the trainings that we give to the cocoa farmers. They can come, we give them advice on how to develop their farms, provide good seedlings, properly grafted seedlings, which they can expect to fruit in a year and a half time.
The beans that we collected from the farmers, it's put into these boxes we call fermentation boxes. It stays there for 48 hours, and because of the quantity of about 400 to 500 kilos per box, it generates heat, and it has to reach something like 45 degrees. Sometimes it reaches up to 48, 49 degrees, and the process of the fermentation is just perfect at that heat. All in all, it's 5 days fermentation. And it's brought up to the solar dryer, and with the sun, the fermentation still continues. That's why it's best to dry it under the sun, because it slowly dries up, and the acidity of the beans is removed because of that steady, slow drying under the sun. So this is the sorting machine. For every 100 grams, for a grade 1A, it's not more than 100. So it should be lesser. In our case, usually we send about 90 beans for every 100 grams. We always want to be in that grade 1A classification.
I have always been that belief that whatever has been given to us, we should preserve and share with your fellow men.